In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a custom header for a Google form. Welcome to Mr. Cook's Corner. Before you get started, one piece of information that you're going to need to know is the size of the header, and that's 1600 by 400. We'll drop a link to that in the description below. The second step is to actually create the banner itself. You've got two main choices. One is to use Google itself and to create a Google slide, or you can use a program like Canva, which lets you be more specific and gives you better design options. Let's start with Canva. From the homepage, you're going to click on Create a Design, and then you're going to choose Custom Dimensions. You want to set the width to 1600 and the height to 400. Make sure it's in PX, which stands for pixels. From there, you're going to use the Canva tools to create your own design. There's a bunch of templates in there you can choose from, or you can just start from scratch. Whenever you're ready, you're going to click on Download, and then you're going to choose either PNG or JPEG. Both work. I prefer PNG though, because you can have transparent backgrounds when you use this type of file. With Google Slides, you're going to start with a blank slide of your choice, or you could pick a theme. You're going to click on File, and then Page Setup. Click on the drop-down box and change it to Custom. Make sure you change inches to pixels first, then set it to 1600 by 400, then click Apply. From there, you're going to use your Google Slides tools to create your design. Whenever you're ready, click on File, then Download, and again, choose either PNG or JPEG. Now all that's left to do is to import this banner into your Google Form. Open the Google Form that you're working on and click on the Art Palette button in the top right. The first choice under Theme Options says Header. Click on Choose Image. Next, click on the middle tab for Upload, and then either drag the file into the box or click on Browse and choose your file. Boom, you're all set and ready to go. Hey, we got plenty more where that came from. Click on one of these boxes to keep your learning going. See you next time at Mr. Cook's Corner.